Unlucky the hero born in this province of the stuck record. History's beaten the hazard. The last crone got burnt up more than 8 decades back with the love hot herb, the talking cat. But the children are better for it. The cow milks cream 1 inch thick. Feed me berries of the dark. Such wrote Sylvia Plath, 1958, the times are tidy, speaking to an economic and political self-satisfied and complacent America after World War II and prior to the Bay of Pigs crisis. And that's what happens when the times are too tidy. There's no opportunity for the hero to perform heroics. And if you're going through the darkness, that's giving you the opportunity to tell an epos tale, to be a hero with 1,000 faces. And without that darkness, you can't perform great deeds. And so if you're a soldier stuck in a time of peace, can I remind you that you shouldn't complain when the darkness comes, and I shouldn't moan when the hard times befall, even though it's so easy for us to succumb to that. We should say, I'm so grateful I've been given the opportunity to perform acts for the annals, feats in the field, deeds of daring, to be the hero with 1,000 faces, who fights the dragon, who gets the treasure, who brings back the boon to the village. I can never go home again because I'm different, but I've left my place of comfort. I followed the wizard guide. If you can be somebody who tells a tale that is worth Homer's epos, then that means there must be darkness. And if there is darkness, it's not something to complain about. Rather, it is the platform that we get to stand upon to tell a heroic myth. Could that solve a lot of the problem of evil, at least for Homo sapiens? Is that something that could really solve it for us? Even the little thing like tripping off a curb or stubbing your toe, or the big tragedies like losing somebody you love, that is all part of a tale that is being told that connects you to the something beyond. To the something beyond. And again, prior to the nuclear war crisis and after World War II and World War I, this was again before Vietnam, 1958, America had become self-satisfied and complacent when it came to the political and economic nature. And Sylvia Plath writes, this is a terrible time for the hero to be born. Unlucky the hero born in this history of the stuck record. Like, this is a bad time to be born because the last witch is gone with her talking cat, her love herb. Like, the last witch got burnt up. She's burnt at the stake. Now, the children are better for it because the cow milks 1 inch thick. Like, but feed me the berries of the dark. Yes, it's good for the kids. Everything's filled with milk and honey and prosperity. But with that has come hedonic adaptation in a time of complacency. And the hedonic adaptation would come because in the 1960s, the hippies would revolt. What I want to tell you is if you're born in unsavory times, maybe it's because you weren't made to be a complacent person who sits on your couch, but rather you were meant to leave the village, to follow the wizard, to win the treasure, to bring back the boon, to overcome the dragon, to win the maiden, and to never go home again, because you were made for a great quest. You were intended to be part of the something beyond.